But it's funny, I was going to make a YouTube video about going to play the golf course. I think it's going to be a YouTube video that ends up being about, like, how the weather can change.
I'm Jason Miller, a full-time professional flight instructor. On the Finer Points channel, you can join me as I bring you tips and tricks that I've learned from 20 years on the flight line. Well, you're joining me here at Palm Springs Airport. We're about to depart for LA. And you can see that I'm not alone this morning. I've got two friends on board.
Good morning. My name is Laura Adden. I'm from Oak Park, Illinois, and we're out here on vacation. This is my very first flight on a private plane, so it's exciting.
I'm Brady Navera, and I'm also from Oak Park, and it's also my first time.
Awesome. Are you guys excited?
We're very excited.
Are you nervous?
A little nervous.
That's all normal, just so you know. Taking my friends to LA was not the only reason I was going there. I was also going to hook up with my friend, this guy, the Ren Baron.
Cherokee 7690 Juliet, Palm Springs Tower, wind calm, fly runway heading, runway 31 left, quick takeoff.
Now, I mention all this because this video is about some tough aeronautical decision making, and I want you to be a part of that process, but I want you to know that these were real external pressures. Like, I really wanted to get my friends to LA, and I really wanted to hook up with Ren Baron, who was waiting for me and expecting us all to arrive.
Group takeoff 31 left, 7690 Juliet.
So I knew I had some nervous passengers. I did a thorough weather briefing the night before. Here's what that looked like. It showed that Santa Monica, our real destination, was probably gonna have an overcast layer just temporarily for the time that we arrived. But there was high pressure dominating Southern California, and our backup plan, Van Nuys, was forecast to be clear all morning and was clear as we were departing here from Palm Springs.
There's those little bumps I was talking about. Just until we get around the corner there, we might feel some of those. You guys doing okay?
Yeah.
All right, good deal. They kind of need...
Cherokee 9-0 Juliet, contact us at Park every day.
Okay, going to departure, good day, 7690 Juliet. SoCal departure, Cherokee 7690 Juliet, 1200, climbing 4500 VFR, Van Nuys.
Right, so something I have to back up and tell you is that, you know, the radio panel in this airplane was pretty thin. And when I rented the aircraft, two different people at Mach 5 Aviation asked me if I was going to go IFR. And I had no intention of going IFR. This was a flight to the desert. This trip to LA was unplanned. So I told them no. I told two different people no. I didn't exactly ask why I shouldn't go IFR. I didn't know if it was there was no static check or if the radios were known to be inaccurate. I had no idea why, but I had no intention of going IFR. So you should know that I said no twice to that question.
The weather report that I just got from Van Nuys said that the fog had rolled in.
Okay.
But we're gonna get a little closer and listen to the actual radio instead of what my iPad says. And we'll start to think of some options. Van Nuys is right around the corner up there. Like, you can kind of see there's a corner, like the mountain kind of comes down into the fog and you can turn right. And that's where Van Nuys is. And I think once we get around that mountain, we'll be able to pick up the actual weather broadcast. Hopefully it'll be the new one and we'll know. And SoCal for 7690 Juliet, are you showing Van Nuys currently IFR?
Let me check. Van Nuys is showing 4 miles this broken ceiling 400.
Yeah, okay, roger that. We'll take it a little bit further. We're going to be unable to fly in there IFR this morning, so I'm just maybe going to wait for the next report and we'll make a decision. There's really no other, I mean, Van Nuys was the backup plan.
Yep.
So if Van Nuys is down and Santa Monica's down, then we're just going to end up going back.
Okay.
And I'll just live with my disappointment. It's funny, when they rented me the plane, they're like, are you going to go IFR? And I was like, no, I have no reason. It's the desert to the mountains. We're not going to go IFR. And here we are.
Now, I know the marine layer very well in California. I mean, it's typical that it will roll in off the ocean in the nighttime, and then as the sun comes up, it'll burn off and sort of roll back. But this day was a little bit different. Every now and again, we get this high pressure weather where the airport will start out clear in the morning. But because, you know, the high pressure air descending toward the earth kind of gets heated up. And as the sun comes up and the temperatures change, the air around the airport will actually turn into fog kind of out of nowhere. It's not like it rolls in per se. It just sort of forms. And it's a little bit backwards because it won't form until the sun comes up. And that's what we were dealing with here. It's the end of March. It's as the seasons are changing. And even though the forecast was to be clear all morning and Van Nuys was clear at the time I departed, when I arrived, it was most certainly IFR. And that is not something that I expected or, to be quite honest, prepared for.
I really apologize, guys, if this ends up being a big air tour.
No worries. You have enough fuel to get back, right?
Oh, yeah, plenty.
Okay, that's all that matters.
Yeah. I'm just heartbroken if I don't get to go play this golf course.
Yeah, I'm sure.
700, turn right, heading 320.
Oh, what a bummer.
I'm going to intercept the localizer for now, the final approach course.
320, intercept the final course, 700.
Brady, we've got all day, so if we have to, we'll drive, okay?
I want you to know, too, that I looked very closely at the weather last night, and this is all unforecast weather.
Yeah, no worries. I mean, it's the ocean. It's the coast. It's got to be unpredictable.
Yeah, well, actually, the ocean is what makes it predictable. It's just every now and again, there's a curveball. But it's funny. I was going to make a YouTube video about going to play the golf course. I think it's going to be a YouTube video that ends up being about, like, how the weather could change, like, last minute. I mean, I even recorded the briefing last night.
SoCal, Cherokee 7690 Juliet, level 4500.
7690 Juliet, SoCal, approach altimeter 2996. Advise when you have information, Charlie, for Van Nuys.
Okay, we'll advise Charlie and 2996, 7690 Juliet.
Cherokee 90 Juliet, do you say you had Charlie for Santa Monica?
Not yet, we're not receiving Charlie yet.
Roger, and what are your intentions?
Well, I was going to continue a bit further to see what the next report says. It's coming up on the top of the hour, but it's likely we'll have to turn around and head back to Palm Springs.
Just let me know what you need to do.
Roger that.
And flight 1930, turn right heading 320.
Right 320, and flight 1930.
And November 9 or 0, Juliet, the weather just came up for Van Nuys, wind 110 at 4, visibility 3 with haze, ceiling 600, overcast.
All right, I guess that solves it for 90 Juliet. We're going to have to head back.
November 90 Juliet, roger. And you going to climb the 55?
That's affirmative, we'll climb 55.
Broadcasting on tower frequency.
I'm sorry, guys.
Okay.
What a bummer.
No worries. It looks pretty thick.
Yeah, it is. I can't tell you how disappointed I am about this.
By 1930, contact SoCal.
Brutal. Just brutal.
2875, and by 1930.
I don't know if I can properly convey what a disappointment this was, what those pressures actually felt like, how tempting it was to possibly just shoot through that marine layer on a GPS approach, even though I said I wouldn't. You know, Ren Baron was waiting for me. He was going to take me golfing at the Bel Air Country Club. I really wanted to get my friends there. It was a tough call to turn around and fly all the way back to Palm Springs, but because of the unforecast weather, that's exactly what I did. So I just wanted to kind of bring you along with that decision making. Sometimes, you know, it's better to turn around, fly away, and live to fly another day, rather than do something in the moment that you think you can do, but you're not entirely sure. In retrospect, I probably should have investigated the IFR possibility a little bit more with that airplane, but the bottom line is I didn't, and there I was, above an undercast, trying to figure out whether or not to fly through a simple 500-foot marine layer. But even that, you just have to draw a line and say, you know what, we can drive here, I can hook up with Ren another day. So anyway, I hope you guys found that helpful to sort of walk through a real-world tough call that I had to make, but there it is. All right, you guys, if you haven't seen the Ground School app, please come get your free 3-day trial. It is a great check ride prep tool. We're adding features all the time. There's tons of bonus content on Patreon, And also a huge thanks to the sponsors. Remember that when you renew your AOPA membership, you should select Pilot Protection Services. Please hit the like button, the alert bell, subscribe to the channel, leave us a comment, share far and wide with your friends. But most importantly, until next time, be safe and fly your best.